We want to determine the equation of a line that is perpendicular to y equals 2x plus 1 and passes through the point with coordinates negative 4, 5. If two lines are perpendicular, that means they intersect and form a right angle or a 90 degree angle. And if two lines are perpendicular, then their slopes are negative reciprocals of one another, which can be written using this notation here, which can be a little bit confusing. So for example, if this first line had a slope of, let's say, 2/5, then the slope of the second line here would have to be the negative reciprocal, meaning we'll flip this over and then change the sign. So it's going to be negative 5/2. Okay, so back to our problem. We want a line that is perpendicular to y equals 2x plus 1. Well, this line is in slope-intercept form, so we should recognize that the slope of this line is 2 over 1. Therefore, the slope of the perpendicular line would be the negative reciprocal of this. So for the slope of our line, we'll have to flip this over and change the sign. That would give us negative 1/2. Negative 1/2 is the negative reciprocal of 2 over 1. And then we know our line also passes through the point negative 4, 5. Now to determine the equation of the line with slope of negative 1/2 containing the point negative 4, 5, we can either use slope-intercept form or the point-slope form of a line. And I think for this video we'll show both. So using just slope-intercept form, or the form y equals mx plus b, we would first substitute negative 1/2 for m. So we'd have y equals negative 1/2 x plus b. And then to determine the y-intercept, it's not going to be positive 5 because the x-coordinate is not 0. But since this point is on the line, that means if we substitute these coordinates into the equation, it should satisfy the equation. So we'll substitute negative 4 for x, 5 for y, and then solve for b. So we'd have 5 equals negative 1/2 times negative 4 plus b. Put the negative 4 over 1. So we have 5 equals, notice how this simplifies here. There's 1, 2, and 2, and 2 2's and 4. So this becomes negative 1 times negative 2. Don't forget about this sign here. So now if we subtract 2 on both sides, we have b equals, this would be positive 3. So now we have our equation. We'll just substitute positive 3 for b, and the equation will be y equals negative 1/2 x plus 3. Now let's go ahead and see if we can get the same equation using point slope form. Point slope form of a line is y minus y1 equals m times the quantity x minus x sub 1, where m is the slope and x sub 1, y sub 1 is a point on the line. So for this situation, x sub 1 is going to be negative 4 and y sub 1 will be positive 5. So we'd have y minus 5 equals negative 1/2 times the quantity x. Now here we'd have minus negative 4, which is the same as plus 4. And now we'll go ahead and solve this equation for y. So we'll distribute here. So we'll have y minus 5 equals, this would be negative 1/2 x. Then here we'd have minus 2. Then the last step to solve for y would be to add 5. This would be 0. So we'd have y equals negative 1/2 x, and this would be plus 3. So notice how if we just use slope-intercept form to determine the equation, or if we use point-slope form to determine the equation, the result is the same. And let's go ahead and quickly verify this graphically. We were given the red line, y equals 2x plus 1, and we determined that the equation of the perpendicular line was y equals negative 1/2 x plus 3. Notice how these two lines do intersect in a right angle here, and the blue line does contain the given point that had coordinates negative 4, 5, this point here. So our work looks good. I hope you found this helpful.